Hello everyone, welcome back to this video on digital communication. In this video, I am going to talk about the mesh filter. So why it is called mesh filter? We are going to find out this answer in this video. So we are going to discuss the mesh filter. First, we are going to discuss its structure, then its SNR, and at last, we are going to study its transfer function. So stay tuned for the detailed discussion of mesh filter. So this is just the part one. In part two, we are going to analyze the mesh filter in more detail. So now first coming to the structure of the mesh filter. So its structure has a receiver filter. So this is the structure of the mesh filter. So here in the input of the receiver filter, so receiver filter, this is the receiver part and this is the transfer function of the receiver, HF or HT. In the time domain it is HT and in the frequency domain the transfer function is HF. So now here just at the input, the signal is represented by XT and noise is represented by NT. So just at the input, the signal and noise are added, which are going to the receiver filter. So now after that, I have the sampling device. So just after the receiver filter, I'll get the YT, which is the output. Now after the sampling device, I'll get the YT. So this Y represents the sampled version of this Y. So now noise is the additive white Gaussian noise. So it's the particular case where my noise is just considered to be additive white Gaussian noise. So now first we'll talk about the SNR. So SNR is equal to gamma square. I'm representing SNR with the help of gamma. It is equal to P square T upon rho square, sigma square. So sigma is my noise power. So now this is my signal power. So PT, I already denoted the PT in my optimal receiver video. So you can go and watch that first. So from where this PT came. So PT was X01 minus X02, where X01 is the output of the first input, which was X1, and X02 is the output of the second input, which was X2. So when I provide the first input X1, I'll get X01 as output. When I'll provide second input, which is X2, I'll get X02 as the output. And PT is the difference between X01 and X02. So now, P output F would be HF into P input F. So this diagram gives me the relation between P output and P input, which is HF into P input F. So this is my P output F. So now I know how I can transfer the frequency domain into time domain. How I can do that? With the help of the Fourier transform or the inverse Fourier transform, I can change the time domain to frequency domain and vice versa. So now here I'll be using the inverse Fourier transform. So P output of time would be equal to minus infinity to infinity P output F e raised to power j 2 pi ft df. So I hope you all are agreeing with me. If I need to find out P output T from P output F, I can take the inverse Fourier transform. So now putting the value of P output F. So P output F was HF into P input F e raised to power j 2 pi FT DF. So now first thing I needed was P square T. So P output square T would be minus infinity to infinity HF P input F e raised to power j 2 pi FT DF square. So this is my P output T square. So now coming to the second part, which is sigma square. Sigma square can be written as E of noise power square n naught t square, or I can write down it as the mean of the power spectral density. So if I talk about the power spectral density, so the relation between an input f, so this is the power spectral density of noise, so it is related with the h square f to the output power spectral density. This is also the power spectral density of output. So now I can say an output f is equal to h square f into n input f. So I hope you all are agreeing with me. So when I consider the additive white Gaussian noise, so which means an input f, the power spectral density of additive white Gaussian noise, I have already made a video on that. I hope you have seen that. So it was equal to n naught by 2. So now I'll just replace NIF with n naught by 2. So now I need to find out the mean. So I can say sigma square is equal to minus infinity to infinity n naught by 2 h square f df. So this will give me the mean. So now if I talk about the SNR, so I just, now I have this term, now I have this term, I just need to divide these terms. So gamma square would be equal to p naught t square, which is minus infinity to infinity hf pif e raised to power j 2 pi f t df square upon minus infinity to infinity n naught by 2, or I can write this n naught by 2 is a constant, so I can write it outside, h square f df. So there is a purpose why I am writing it outside. So now I know the Schwarz inequality. So according to the Schwarz inequality, if I have two function xf and yf, the integration from minus infinity to infinity of xf yf square is less than equal to the integration of x square f over minus infinity to infinity into the integration of y square f over minus infinity to infinity. So now here, from here I am taking my xf to be hf, and now yf would be, yf is pif e raised to power j 2 pi f t. So now putting these values in this formula, so minus infinity to infinity, my xf is hf into yf is pif e raised to power j 2 pi f t is less than equal to minus infinity to infinity x square f h square f df into minus infinity to infinity y square f. So it would be pi square f e raised to power j 2 pi f t. So now when I took this h square f df integration from minus infinity to infinity, here this side in the denominator, so now it would be lesser than, so here df was also there, pi square f df. So I am taking its value to be 1 and it is always lesser than this as well. So now if I talk about this equation, so this equation and this equation are same, I just need to divide it by n naught by 2. So here also, if I divide here by n naught by 2, here also I'll divide by n naught by 2. So now this is my gamma. Now So now SNR gamma is less than equal to, so because here I put this value to be 1, so now this gamma is my maximum value. So now it is equal to minus infinity to infinity pi square f df into 2 by n naught. So now this is my gamma, which is the SNR. So this is my SNR of meshed filter. So now, according to the Schwarz inequality, the second condition was xf is equal to kyf conjugate. So now, putting the value of xf and yf, so that time I'll find out the transfer function hf. So when I put the value of xf, xf is hf is equal to k into y star, so it would be p star f e raised to power j. The conjugate of e raised to power j would be e raised to power minus j 2 pi f t. So now this is my h of f. So now this is my transfer function in frequency domain. So now if I find out the transfer function in time domain, so what I can do, h of t would be minus infinity to infinity h of f e raised to power j 2 pi f t df. So now I can take the inverse Fourier transform and I can find out the transfer function in the time domain. So we'll analyze the transfer function and the SNR in the time domain in my next video. So till this video, I hope you understood the SNR is less than equal to 2 by n naught minus infinity to infinity pi square f df. So let's write it clearly. So now you can see the SNR. So gamma square max, I am taking it to be equal to 2 by n naught minus infinity to infinity pi square f df. So now you can see the SNR depends upon the input signal only. So which is why it is called meshed filter. So I hope now you can see why it is called the meshed filter. Now we'll analyze the SNR and the transfer function in the time domain as well, and we can see after that as well that why it is called the meshed filter and what are the parameters in the time domain. So these are the parameters in the frequency domain only. So when I'll talk about the time domain in my next video, you can see what are the parameters in the time domain. So I'll conclude my session here. I hope you understood all of the things which I discussed here. Still, if you have any doubt in any point in this video, you can put the doubt in the comment and I'll try to resolve it as soon as possible. I hope you like this video. If you like it, share it with your friends, subscribe to the channel and push the like button. Thank you.